Hey, this is Matt once again. I'm got the dog in the car now. You can't see him from this angle. He might run up here. You see him in a second. Dog named Scout. That's my mom's dog. I think we'll get a shot of him when we get to where we're going and get a couple pictures of him. Show a different sides of our lives and whatnot, and different animals. I'm gonna put some shots of my cat up. Not just cats, a whole bunch of them. But, anyway, I know the last video got cut off. The SD card ran out of a memory right before my last sentence. I didn't know that. So, I didn't say much else. I was speaking about that there's no God judging people. You know, there's creative forces and beings, but there's no God on the throne. Sending people to hell or heaven, making that choice. And you don't have to believe in any certain being in order not to be thrown in some hell and whatnot. It doesn't matter what religion you believe in, just as long as you're a good person, I think that's all that matters. And even if you're not a good person, if you've done bad things, you've hurt people, if you've even if you killed people, a lot of people, it's still alright, you know. I was going to touch on this. You might have seen the video that we put up of, this camera's doing this again. I'm sorry, I'm gonna mount this thing on the dashboard soon with Velcro. Make it a lot easier, a lot simpler than mounting a whole tripod and a Mountaineer. It's a pain. But anyway, you might have seen the video we did back right before Thanksgiving of Jay. We called him Jay. His name started with Jay, something like that. Sometimes when we do channelings, names don't come through clearly. It's like they're trying to say names aren't that critical. And anyway, a lot of times they use different names in the spirit world anyway, their real names. So, let me get this camera straight. This is starting to irritate me. They use different names, though, in the spirit world. You know, I think they have a permanent name, some of them that they choose to use. But anyway, well, getting back to the subject, the guy's name was Jay, or is Jay. And we didn't ask him to come through. We didn't think about it. You know, he just popped through because it was important. He had something critical he wanted to say. And he wanted to talk about gang violence. And the dude was... as you've probably seen in the video, dude was a gangbanger, of course. You know, he crossed over in 1984, and he was his set was called the Wets, something like that, in West Side Chicago, Wets, something like that. But after we did that session, I looked up online trying to research and see what was said about that set, and there's nothing much on it except on one website. And there was a gang in almost unknown one in West Side of Chicago called, I forgot what it was, Wets Posse or something like that, but it was Wets. So this stuff is accurate, but he wanted to talk about that. And he's not the only one we've talked to. We've talked to quite a few gangbangers, quite a few. And they come through all the time. They have a lot to teach. And, you know, this is probably a good subject when we talk about there being no angry God throwing people in hell for killing people and stuff like that. And the reason is that nobody ever died. It's just a dream, almost an illusion of death. That's all death is. It's just an illusion. That's it. You know, so when the when those bangers are out killing enemies, right, you know, enemy sets, they weren't really killing anybody. They were sending them to what we might term heaven. They're actually sending them to the universe, to a better life. They actually did them a favor. I know that's hard to comprehend, but it's hard to even for some people to consider that, to even believe that. But let me assure you, it is true. You know, when people die, no matter how they die, they're actually in a better position than here. This is suffering. Like the Buddha said, this world is just plain suffering. And you're relieved of that suffering upon leaving physical life. But anyway, a lot of them have good things to say, man. You know, they all hang out over there, and they're all friends, and you know, we've been told by every single one of them that what we might call enemies from rival sets that they had killed in the physical life were there meeting them upon their own death, you know. But they weren't there to fight or be angry. They were there to forgive and bestow compassion and love and offer friendship and so forth. And all the colors blend together on the other side. And you know, they all hang out together over there. They party together. You know, they didn't get along in this life, but then they come together after this life and death. So that's one of the most hopeful things I've ever heard in my life. You know, that's one of the most hopeful things. One of the most beautiful things I've heard, man. You know, that stuff like that actually happens, and it's truth. You know, we talked to another dude last fall of 2008, not this, you know, not fall of this year, but we were riding this very same car. The position the camera in is where the dude was sitting, both of them, but in the car, they're kind of sitting up on the dashboard, you know, while we were talking to them. But, a blood OG from a content set had come through, and he was real good, man, talking about snake in the cage. That's what he said gangbanging was like when he was banging in this world. So he felt like he was in a cage with a snake, and he was, said he was always looking out for the snake, always worried about the snake, you know, always wondering if it was going to get him that day. And then when he crossed over, he said he kept looking around for that snake, but shit, it was never there. He kept looking, but it wasn't there. And that's real interesting stuff. I like that analogy. Right after we talked to him, a dude, I think his name was Jackson, I think, or something similar to that. And he was from a Crip set in Compton, and he wanted to talk too. He saw us there talking to other G's, and came on through. I wanted to say to both of them, I can see them in my mind right now. In my Jeremy sees spirits right in front of him, like a hologram. I as far as channeling, seeing stuff like that, I've seen it before, but not regularly and all the time like he does. I see them in my mind. Image pops through immediately, clear as day. And you know, because thoughts draw them to you. When you're thinking about someone who's crossed over or died or whatever, they know instantly that you thought about them, no matter how little the thought is. And then when I mentioned those two G's there, and they knew it. And, you know, as soon as I said those words, they were here. Now, I didn't mean to bother you guys, but I just, you know, I think you already know that we're putting this stuff up for the world right now, for everybody to learn from. But anyway, I'm just kind of cruising around. I gotta get out and walk this dog. He's gotta pee. I know that. He's kind of antsy and whimpering. So let me get this done. I'll pick it back up in a second. Keep taping. But look at it this way, though. If gangbangers spend their whole lives killing people from enemy sets and stuff like that, and fighting with one another, are worthy of forgiveness and love, and then they're not punished. I mean, what do you think happens to other people who do bad things? What does that tell you about the universe? What does that tell you about the nature of God? I wrote about this in a blog entry too. There's more details on that if you read the blog, diaryofapsychicmedium.wordpress.com. But anyway,